Our next speaker really doesn't need an introduction. Out next, quite honestly, we have a great, great part of the program. But we do have to take a moment to share a few words about our very special guest. Many of you are fans of her financial advice show on CNBC television. And since we're in Las Vegas, I'm betting that some of you have thought about a much-needed vacation or a new car or wondered, can I afford it? And I'll bet again that your next thought is, what would Susie say? Yes, Susie Orman gave an acclaimed talk to our leaders several years ago, and in many ways, NCLR and Susie Orman are working on similar goals. We want the people we work with to be smart, educated consumers. We want these folks to think about and plan for their future, whether it's a home, a college education, or retirement. She is one of the most listened to and respected personal finance experts in the world today. I hope that you will join me in turning to the screen to hear just a little bit more about the fabulous Susie Orman.
It's the place I want you to come when it comes to personal finance.
When you become more powerful, you'll be able to go out there and earn more money.
The Susie Orman Show is about stopping the mistakes right now.
We gotta get everybody together in the financial bedroom.
Do they show the Susie Orman Show over in Japan?
Yes, ma'am, on Sunday.
I like that.
I am asking you to get a grip on reality.
I seriously care about your money, but oh no, you obviously don't care about it as much as I
what
do.
What are you thinking?
I'm a little rambunctious tonight, what you say?
I got a feeling.
I love you. I just love you.
That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. Tonight's the night.
The Emmy goes to
Susie Orman.
We all know that Susie does not sugarcoat anything.
This is a want. This is not a need.
She's not one to say, I told you so.
Oh, if you had listened to me, you would have made a lot of money.
Personal finance expert, best-selling author,
Susie Orman.
You're at the big board, Susie Orman.
You can just go and do an app. This is like taking a little Susie Orman with you.
Susie, where do you get your jackets?
And then we'll do it again.
Show me the money.
You are so not gonna do that, I can't even begin to tell you.
You got me begging you for money.
You wanna spend what on what? You are denied! Ah! You're denied! Ah!
Tonight. Just one more night.
People first, then money, then things. Now you stay safe.
Please join me in welcoming someone who cares about you and your success, the amazing Susie Orman.
I would come out here and I would say, buenas tardes. However, then I would have to say, can you help me with my Spanish if I help you with your money? But I'm gonna say, good afternoon, and are you ready to change your lives, really? Now listen to me. You cannot come to a conference where the theme of this conference is lead the way, if you are not leading your own way with your own money. Now, I understand very well there are many of you out there that are in charge of nonprofit organizations. You work day in and day out to make sure everybody else is okay. We are going to change that, because while you can make others okay, You cannot transform your community. You cannot transform the lives of how other people even think about you unless you have changed your own life. Now, Nelly, I love you more than life itself. I love everything that you said, but I'm not going to tell these people how to spend their chips. You're not going to spend your chips, especially here in Las Vegas. Do you understand me? I'm going to tell you how to save money. And Nellie, if their husbands come to them, the women in this room, to ask them for money, here's what they're going to say. Are you kidding? It's my money. If you want money, go on and get some of your own. The day has come, truthfully, the day has come that especially the women in this room understand that if you want to be the strong, powerful women that you are meant to be, then you have got to save yourselves before you save anybody else. The money that you make, the money that I want you to make, the money that Nelly and Coca-Cola is wanting to help you make will not do you any good when you get that money and you say to everybody, here, it's for you. Here, you take care of yourself with it. If you don't use it to save yourself, you are rendering yourselves powerless. Have you ever noticed when you get on an airplane, they say to you, when the oxygen mask falls down, you are to put it on your children's face first, then yours. Because if something happens, right? Oh, wrong. Oh, you caught that. Because if something happens and you put it on your children's face and not yours, you would be dead. And then who's going to take care of the children? But that's what you hear in your head. And the truth of the matter is what they are really saying, and they're saying it to remind you, even though you won't hear it, is to put it on your face first. The same is true with money. If you don't take care of yourselves first, really, who is going to be there then to take care of your children? Now, we live at a time where the economy, and you heard the Attorney General talk about this a little bit, where especially in this state, but it's not just this state, it's throughout the entire United States, where many of you have lost or are in the process of losing your homes. The jobs aren't there. The loans aren't there. Sure, interest rates are at all-time lows, but nobody's making money available to you. What you have to understand is you cannot wait for the administration to save you. You cannot wait for the government or banks or credit companies or whatever it is to save you. You have got to, right here and today, vow that you are going to start to take actions to save yourselves. Now, how do you do that? The reason that I'm not letting you applaud is because I see I only have a few minutes here, so I want to make sure that I get everything out because I have so much to tell you. I could take the whole rest of the day, but I don't think they would like that. All right, so how do you do that? You have to stop wasting money. You have to start making more out of less money. You have to start to adopt the attitude that you are not victims to your circumstances. You are victors. Nobody out there can keep you down. Nobody can keep you from having less. Nobody can stop you but you and you alone. You saw what Nelly did with her life. Maybe you know a little bit about my life, maybe you don't. But I can tell you, if you don't, I stand up here in front of you at the age of 61. I look good, don't I? But I stand up here in front of you at the age of 61, a very powerful woman today. But it wasn't always like that. Do you know that I was still a waitress till the age of 30, having had been a waitress for 7 years, making $400 a month? My mother was a secretary. We lived on the south side of Chicago. Right? Mm-hmm. For those of them are hooting, and for those of you who don't know, the true south side of Chicago, 81st and Oglesby, was known as the Hood. I was one of the only white faces in a sea of black faces. We didn't have any money. I was never supposed to amount to anything. I was so proud to be a waitress. I never got a grade above a C. Everything was working against me. So how do I end up here? I end up here because after 7 years working as a waitress, I wanted to open up my own restaurant. I had a little tiny thought that Nellie probably put in my mind before she even knew me, that I wanted my own chips. And so I asked my mom for $20,000. Now, if she had been Latina, she would have given it to me. But she wasn't. And she said, "No, Susie, we don't have money to give you." And I said, "Okay, Mom." And I went to work the next day. And everybody noticed that I wasn't very happy. And it got out, the story about what happened, that I want to open my own restaurant. And the customers I had been waiting on gave me $50,000 to open up a restaurant. But I didn't know what to do with that money. So they said, "Susie, go and take it to the local Merrill Lynch office and keep it in a money market account until we can help you." Well, I didn't know what a Merrill Lynch was. I didn't know what a money market account was, so they physically had to take me and show me. I opened up an account, and to make a very long story short, within 3 months, all $50,000 was lost. Oh, did you hear what you just did? You went, "Oh." The problem is this. If that hadn't happened to me, I would not be standing here in front of you today. When one door closes, another one opens. Every no leads you that much closer to a yes. So every single thing that happens in your life, you need to choose to look at it like, "Thank you, God. Thank you for having this happen to me. Thank you for showing me I am stronger than I even know, because nothing is going to keep me down." So I thought, okay, all money was lost. Now what am I going to do? I go, "I know, I can be a broker. They just make you broker." So I went dressed in my red and white striped Sassoon pants, tucked into my white cowboy boots with a blue silk shirt. That was the fanciest clothes I had. I was a waitress. I went. I was a size 6 back then. I looked hot. Oy. All right. That's the only thing I wouldn't mind going back to. But besides that, I go. And now I find myself in the manager's office because they don't know what to do with me. There were no women stockbrokers back then. This was 1980. And they especially didn't expect one that looked like this. And the manager says, "Well, listen to me. We're going to hire you." He didn't say it to fill their women's quota. But we're going to hire you. "But trust me, within 6 months, you're going to be out of here. Because in my opinion, women belong barefoot and pregnant." Mm-hmm. His name was Peter Sansevero. I love telling this story on television. And I know we're live streaming right now, so I hope everybody out there hears it. And I said, "Well, how much are you going to pay me to make me pregnant?" He told me $1,500 a month. Didn't take me long to figure out that's like working for 2 years as a waitress. I took the job. As a financial advisor now, I learned that what Merrill Lynch did was wrong, and that they had a crooked financial advisor who took advantage of me. So I went into Peter's office, and I said, "Peter, you have a crook that took advantage of me. I want my money back." He said, "Susie, that crook makes us a lot of money. Go and sit down and don't say anything." So I went to my little cubicle, and I thought to myself, you know, he said I was going to be out of here in 6 months, and it was 4 months into this. So I thought, I could sit there and I could say nothing. That would be easy, but it wouldn't be right. When something happens to you and somebody takes advantage of you, you can all sit there and you could say nothing because that's easy, but it is not right. Because I thought to myself, it's not. I thought, you know, all right, I'm still young, maybe I could figure out how to pay everybody back, whatever. But what if it was my mother or my grandmother or somebody who didn't have the health to earn this money back? So I did the only thing that I knew what to do back at that time, and I sued Merrill Lynch while I was working for them. Here's what I didn't know. Because I sued them, they couldn't fire me. 2 years later, before it went to court, they did give me all the money back. Why? Because I was their number six producing broker, and I was more valuable to them with the firm than outside of the firm. Now, I don't tell you that story to impress you, although you seriously should be. I tell you that story to inspire you. To inspire you to do what is right versus doing what is easy. When you are oppressed, when somebody is denying you coverage for whether it's a life insurance policy or a job because you don't have a credit report or whatever it may be, it is not right for you to stay silent anymore. You are the leaders of this community. You are the ones who need a voice, and you need a powerful voice. And I am here to tell you what makes you powerful is when you have money. What you think about it, what you feel about it, and what you do with it is what gives you the power to do the things you need to do to help yourself as well as to help others. Now, the economy is down. And I don't know when this economy is really going to come back. Back in 2008, I went on every single television show and I said it would not be until 2015. Everybody said, oh, please, Susie, it'll be 2 years. I said, I don't think so. We're in trouble. We're in big trouble. And you know we're in big trouble when, and Rosie could probably tell you this, when even in Washington, they don't know how to fix anything, do they? You don't have to answer, fine, right? I'll tell you that. There are no answers to the problems that were created because nobody has ever seen problems like this before because they were man-made. I'm not going to accuse women of doing this to us. But men, I love you anyway, trust me. But no, but truthfully, we did this to ourselves and we don't know how to get out of it really. So you have to make sure that every single penny that you have is put to good use now. Do I think we're going to be okay? You betcha I do. But I still think that we're 3 years away. So you have to know the correct actions to take. So let's just start with how do you take care of yourselves? What can you do now to protect what you do have or what you want to have? I am sure if I were to ask those of you in this room, do you have a will? Do you have a trust? Do you have a durable power of attorney for health care? Do you have an advance directive? You would be looking at me and saying, what is she talking about? These documents that I just named are the four must-have documents. The less money you have, the more you need documents in place to protect you. If you simply have a will and it says your assets are to go to your family, the family that you care about, that you're giving everything to, well, if you really want to take care of them, you wouldn't just have a will. You would also have a living revocable trust. Because if you simply had a will that says where your assets are to go upon your death, chances are that will has to go to probate court. It could take 6 months to 2 years to go through probate court. It's going to cost you $1,000 or $2,000 to get into probate court. You might not even know what probate court is. And then if you have money, they could take 4 to 5% of that to pay the lawyers, the executors, and everybody else. You need legal documents in place. If you simply had a living revocable trust, you could simply transfer things now into the title of the trust. Now, I could go on and on, but I'm not. Here, I have a gift for all of you. Every single one of you in this room needs a will, a living revocable trust, and the must-have documents. You are to go on to SusieOrman.com. When you get there, you are to look at where it says Susie's books, kits, things like that. You'll click on it. Up will come where it says must have documents, and then it's going to show you a gift login code. If you put in lead the way, if you can't remember lead the way, just remember NCLR. Okay, either one will work. If you do that, you will be able to download over $2,500 worth of state-of-the-art documents. All you have to do is answer the questions. Up will come the documents that you need in your particular situation. It is not one size fits all. This program has artificial intelligence in it. It is good in all 50 states, good on Macs and PCs. Now, if you were really responsible, you just wouldn't use this. You would make sure every single Latina that you see, every single newspaper that you write, every single person that you come in contact with, you will give them this passcode. And you will make sure that they are protected. This is a passcode that I'm going to leave up there for at least a year. It's because I know you're slow to act. But I want you to act. I want you to take care of yourselves. The documents that you are about to download, this is my will, my trust, my advance directive. The documents that I have to protect my estate are these exact same documents. So if they're good enough for the personal finance expert of the world, they are good enough for you, ladies and gentlemen. Right. Next, while you are on my website, because one of the biggest mistakes that many of you make is you buy the wrong type of insurance. So for instance, if you have whole life, universal, or variable life insurance, I'm here to tell you, you're making one of the biggest mistakes in your life. The only type of insurance you should have is term insurance. You're probably paying too much insurance for your car, for your homes if you have it. So while you're on my website, look at that same place, books and logins, look to where it says the insurance kit. Use the same login. Fill it out. It again has my little brain in it, and it will tell you exactly what type of policies you should have. Are you overinsured, underinsured? It will save you $300 to $500 easily on the policies that you already have. Next, all right, you're out there and you are spending money, and some of you are wasting money. And some of you are wasting money, why? Because many of you refuse to deal with a bank. Many of you are either unbanked or underbanked. And when you pay for everything in cash or on a debit card or with a money order, do you understand that none of those transactions get reported to a credit bureau? Because they don't get reported to a credit bureau, they therefore do not create a FICO or a credit score for you. Now listen to me closely. Because you may not have a FICO score or a credit score, either one, you may not be able to rent an apartment. Good luck getting a loan from a bank or a credit union to buy a car or a home. And if you do get a loan, you are going to pay incredibly high interest rates. If you have a low FICO score, none at all, do you know that you pay more in car insurance premiums and your insurance premiums across the board are higher? So because you are taking actions that don't lead to a high FICO score, you are spending more on everything that most of you do, when the truth is you could be spending less. And at times like this, it is essential that you spend less when you can, so you can save more. To that end, I created something, and I am asking you to help me with this. Because when I brought this out in January, the financial institutions, the other prepaid cards there, people who are making a fortune off of your ignorance, want to shut me down. They did everything in their power to say, this cannot happen. Susie Orman cannot do this. We will start to lose millions of dollars if she succeeds. But like Nellie, nothing can keep that woman down, and nothing can keep this woman down. Can you imagine if the two of us joined forces? So I did create what's known as the approved card. I did not just bring out this card so that there could be another prepaid card in the industry. There are many prepaid cards in the industry. I brought out this prepaid card to do two things. Number one, give you a cost-effective way to truthfully do business. Yes, there's a fee on this card. It is $3 a month. But if you use this card exactly like I tell you to, it will never cost you more than $3 per month. And that $3 is not just for one card, it's up to four cards. So it could be 75 cents a month apiece. This card comes with free identity theft protection, unlimited credit reports and scores from TransUnion, 24/7 credit monitoring from TransUnion, all free. If you direct deposit a cent a month, no minimum, you can take out from the Allpoint ATM systems any money you want absolutely free as many times as you want. You have free online bill pay, free card-to-card transfers. Hey, if somebody in your family needs money, you could transfer from your card to their card and it doesn't cost you a penny. I have done absolutely everything on this card to bring you a card that is cost effective. And when I have my way, that $3 a month will go away. Because money should be free, but somebody's got to pay for the telephone calls and everything else. I don't think $3 is too much to ask. However, this is the real reason I brought out this card. Currently, when you use a debit card, it does not report to a credit bureau. I told you that. I want to change the credit scoring system in the United States of America, and I need your help to do so. I want it to be inclusive of you, not exclusive. I want you to be rewarded for paying for things on a debit card, not penalized for doing it. I want you to be penalized if you're paying on credit and only paying the minimum payment due. Why should you have a good credit score because you're doing that versus being responsible and paying in cash? Something is wrong with the system. So help me fix it, people. Here's how. For the next few months, the data that is coming off of this card, the approved card, and you would go to theapprovedcard.com to get one, is being analyzed by TransUnion, one of the three major credit bureaus out there. They are finding, and they are happy about what they are finding, that this possibly could predict future behavior when you pay your rent on a debit card, you pay your utilities on a debit card, you don't spend, but you pay your bills on a card. It is possible that in the next 6 months to 1 year, TransUnion will deem that activity on a prepaid card will be included on their credit reports. If it's included on their credit reports, it is going to generate a credit score for you. That is history making, but nobody out there wants me to succeed because there is big business, big money in you staying poor, in you paying fees, in you paying more in insurance, and you paying more all the way around. Are you understanding the mission that I am on? But you have got to look at your finances with this same passion that I'm talking to you with the same passion that I'm doing this card with. I am losing a fortune on this card. I've already put in almost $2 million of my own money. It is costing me tens of thousands of dollars a month to keep it going, but I am going to keep it going until it works because you deserve to have a vehicle like my approved card. If I can be doing that for you, can you just help me help you? But it's not just helping you with what do you do with a prepaid card or not. Do you have a will or trust or not? Do you have the right insurance or not? You have got to start taking care of yourselves. So you have got to have a Roth IRA. A Roth IRA is the absolute best type of retirement account you can have, bar none. I don't care if you have to put $10 a month into it or something, you have to start somewhere. The main message that I want to leave you with today is very simple. It's a message of, I am asking you to look within to see why you're doing without. I'm asking you to stop blaming the fact that you're a minority, that nobody cares about you, and put that aside. And I am asking you to lead the way, not just for yourselves, but for the entire Latina community, for the entire world, because it can start here, right here today. You have the most extraordinary leaders I've ever seen, but you're not doing what you need to do to keep yourself financially afloat. That's the message that I wanted to leave you with. But I'm also here to really answer your questions. So we have about 5 minutes. If you have a question out there, what is it that you would like to know from me? Do we have anybody? Are you resonating with this, everyone? Janet, is there anything else you want me to tell them?
Susie, can you tell us what the biggest obstacle for Latinas to build wealth is?
I would probably say their opinions of themselves and that they're not worthy to do so. And I'm serious about that, is that it's so easy to just stay oppressed. It is so easy to say there are no tools or things for me out there. It's hard to have the courage to be rich. You know, a while ago I wrote a book called The Courage to Be Rich, back in 1999 now. It was the third book I wrote. And the publisher didn't like that name. They wanted to say, Susie, it doesn't take courage to be rich, right? You know, it takes courage to be poor. And I said, no, it doesn't. Anybody could be poor. It takes courage to open up your credit card statements. It takes courage to be able to look and call a creditor and say, I don't have the money to pay the bills. Keep calling me. I will answer your calls rather than run away. It takes courage to say, I am going to do this against all odds. It takes courage to stand up and ask for your rights. It takes courage to say, you may want to keep me down, America, but I'm going to pull myself up. That's what you have to have. And the people in this room can have it. Now, I'm telling you, obviously, nobody has given you a break. Of course, everybody wants you to stay down. Don't you understand? There is millions and millions of dollars in poverty. The more you don't know about your money, the more you don't want to get involved with your money, the more money people can make off of you in late fees and these high prepaid card charges and the insurance that they charge you and everything else. And you just say, okay, you can financially rape me. And that's essentially what it is. Or you could stand up and you can say, not anymore. Not anymore. I'm not going to pay those kind of fees. I'm going to do it, and I'm going to educate myself. I have asked Janet to let me partner with La Raza. I was not paid to be here today, right? I don't want any money from you. I want money for you. And I have asked Janet for no fees. I don't care about what I make. Let me work with you, and let me create the financial literacy that you really need that can pick you up. Not this stuff that's boring and this, the stocks and the, oh, who gives a damn about that stuff? Let's talk about how to get out of credit card debt. How much insurance should you have? Should you buy a home? Should you not buy a home? If you had the education that you had needed, you wouldn't be having the foreclosures that you are having today. But they made money off of you. They didn't lose it. You lost it. So I'm here to help you gain it. So that's what it is. All right, another question. Wait, I think they have microphones. Yes, sir.
Hi, Susie, how are you?
I'm fabulous, sir.
Eric Rivera, comedian, ericrivera.com. Thank you. As a self-employed Latina, what steps can I take to start planning for my retirement?
Do you have credit card debt?
Yes.
How much?
A lot.
How much, I asked you?
A couple thousand.
Couple thousand at what interest rate?
my wife handles the money.
Now, why is this that I have this gut feeling that she handles the money that you've spent on being cool? What was your website? No, but
SusieOrman.com.
Yeah. Here's the thing, right? You can't think about saving for your retirement when you have debt. Debt is bondage, and you can never have financial freedom if you are in bondage. Chances are the interest rates on these cards are at 15, 18, 29%. Chances are your FICO scores are low. So you're spending money all over the place. So to change your situation around, you have got to vow today to make it your number one priority to get out of credit card debt and stay out of credit card debt. Once you're out of credit card debt, now you have to build an 8-month emergency fund. After an 8-month emergency fund, then you start to do other things. There's all kinds of ways. Watch the Susie Orman Show every Saturday night on CNBC. Now listen to me, if you don't have cable, because cable's expensive. I think it is a travesty that we have to pay as much as we have to pay to watch what we should. So I have put the shows on iTunes for free. So all of you have a smartphone. All of you have internet connection. So you can watch the Susie Orman Show for free on iTunes, especially if you don't have cable. So, but watch, and every week, for 12 years now, we're the number one rated show on CNBC. For 12 years, I have dealt with the people who don't have money. All financial advisors want to deal with you if you have money. If you don't have money, they don't care about you. Susie Orman cares about you. Susie Orman cares about you to give you the gifts that you need enough to know enough about to take care of yourselves. Please take advantage of those gifts. To bring a card at my own expense so you can start turning things around, to change the credit scoring system of the United States of America, and to give you the information that you need to know today to truthfully protect your tomorrows. Can you do it? Without a shadow of a doubt, you can. But you have to care enough about yourselves to make this dream a reality. I wish you all the best, honest to God I do, and I better see a lot of clicks on my site with downloads of the will and trust in the insurance programs. Do you hear me? All right. Thank you, everybody. Bye-bye.